Good morning, everyone. Welcome to our Monday morning worship. Hope you're all keeping well. It's been lovely over the last week to receive some of your entries for our second creativity challenge, where you've been sharing some of your ideas about what we might find on the other side of this lockdown and through your magical doors. We'll come to those later in our worship time. First of all, though, I just wanted to make a special mention of one of our year one children. You'll remember our aspiration challenge from 2 or 3 weeks back, when lots of you sent in, let us know some of the things that you were aspiring towards, that you were trying to achieve, perhaps some new skills, and there were loads of different ideas, which was lovely. Now this particular young lady wanted to learn to ride her bike, and she was putting a lot of effort into doing that. And on Friday, it was lovely for me to receive this little video from her. What a super example of our values of perseverance and aspiration. She's aspired to achieve something. She's worked hard and she's achieved it. So really, really well done. Very, very proud of you. That's absolutely fantastic. Keep up the good work and enjoy your cycling. Right, the values that we're going to be looking at this week, there are two of them from our school values, love and forgiveness. Probably, I think, two of the most important of our values. So to help us to do this, as usual, we're going to enjoy a story from the Bible. This is another story that Jesus told, so it's a parable, a story with a message, and it's the story of the lost son. Once upon a time, there was a man who had two sons. He loved them both very much, but one day the younger son came to him with a request, a rather sad request. "Father," the younger son said, "when you die, I will get part of your money and part of your land. The problem is, I don't want to wait until you die. I want my money now." It was all the father could do to hold back his tears. But because he loved his son, he agreed and he gave him his share of the money. That very day, the son left home, money in his pocket, big smile on his face. He didn't even say goodbye. The father just watched, wiped a tear away, and hoped that one day he would see his son again. The son travelled to a country far, far away and spent his money just as fast as he could. He drank, he gambled, he used his money to do many bad things until, predictably, finally, the money was gone. The son looked for a job, but the only work he could find was taking care of pigs. It was hard, dirty work, and he was so hungry sometimes that he thought about taking the pigs' food for himself. He was miserable, he was lonely, and he was sad. And then one day he had an idea. "The servants who take care of my father's animals are much happier now. I'll go home. That's what I'll do. I'll tell my father how sorry I am for wasting his money. And maybe, just maybe, maybe he'll let me be a servant and work for him." Now, what do you think the father had been doing all this time? Did he say to himself, "I've got my eldest son at home with me. He's been good. Who cares if my younger son's gone?" No, of course he didn't. He loved his son, even though he'd gone far away. And every day he would go out to the roadside and watch, hoping his son would return. And that's exactly where he was when the younger son hobbled into sight, poor and hungry. The father ran to his son and hugged him tight, and the son dropped right to his knees. "Oh, father," he cried, "I am so sorry. I've wasted all your money and I'm no longer good enough to be called your son." "Don't be silly," said his father. "You are my son. You will always be my son. And I am so glad to have you back." Then the father lifted his son to his feet and walked him home. He dressed him in beautiful clothes. He put gold rings on his fingers and he threw him a big welcome home party. When the elder son came home from work that night, he heard the party noise. "What's happening?" he asked. And when a servant told him, he was filled with anger and ran to his father. "It's not fair," he shouted. "I've been a good son. I've worked hard for you all these years. But he was bad. He wasted your money. And now you're throwing him a party." "I love you, my son," the father said. "And you have enjoyed all the good things I have. But your brother was gone. And now he's back. He was lost. And now he's found. That's why I'm having this party, because we're all back together again." Now, this is one of my favourite stories in the Bible because I think it really shows what love is about. The father never stopped loving his son, did he? Even when his son took his money, even when his son left home and didn't even bother to say goodbye, even when the son was gone for many, many years, even when the father knew that his son had wasted all the money that he'd worked all his life to earn. And as soon as the son realised his mistakes and came back to say sorry, his father was there, ready, waiting to forgive him. I think this is real love. Jesus told this story to show us what God's love is like, how God never stops loving us, no matter what we do wrong, no matter how much we ignore him, and no matter how far we move away from him. Jesus was teaching his people that God is always there, ready and waiting to forgive us and to welcome us back with open arms. He wanted everyone to know that it's never too late for a fresh start. What a fabulous message, and what a brilliant example to everyone of how we should love each other, and how we should be ready to forgive each other when we make mistakes or when we hurt each other. Now, your challenge this week is all about love. And in fact, it's all about spreading love. We often sing in school, love is like a magic penny, hold it tight and you won't have any, but lend it, spend it, give it away, and you'll have so many they'll roll all over the floor. The more love we give out, the more kindness we spread, the more kind things we do, the more we forgive each other, and the more love and forgiveness we'll receive back. Right now, we might find that there are times in our homes when our families really annoy us. And we do something or say something we might regret, or they do something or say something that they might regret to hurt us. And there are almost certain to be times when we need to forgive each other. We can all get a bit annoyed, can't we, with each other when we spend so much time together. If we forgive someone, there's much more chance that they'll forgive us. If we do something kind for someone, there's every chance that at some point they'll do something kind to us. If we smile at someone, what do you normally get back? A smile. If we do kind things for each other, maybe making a drink for someone, or tidying up, or helping in the garden, or just giving a smile or a little message or a card, then we're likely to get a lot more love back. And love spreads happiness, and happiness spreads more love. So that's what your challenge for this week is, to share the love. It's the share the love challenge, with your families. But actually, I also want you to share some love with people that you don't get to see at the moment, people you don't get to see every day, with your neighbours, and those who might walk past your home. And because this week, I'd like you all to design a poster to stick up in your window to cheer people up as they walk past, perhaps on their daily walks. Your poster should include a message for people to read. Just a few words, maybe a message of encouragement or hope. Perhaps you want to say, keep on smiling, or everyone's special, or never give up, or remember God loves you. Or maybe you want to encourage people to share some love today, or do one kind thing, or forgive someone today. The message that you give is up to you to decide, but it should be about sharing some love or kindness in our world. Make your posters as colourful and attractive as you can so that people see them and so they make them smile. Some of you, I know, have got some cuddly toys that you are really, really keen on and that you really love. If you can, and if you want to, you might want to get one of your cuddly toys, one of your favourite toys, to hold your message in some way in the window. That could really make people smile, couldn't it, if you want to do that. Now then, if you'd like to, I'm going to invite you to join us as we pray again. It's another prayer from our values prayer book. This one is another one from the love section of our prayer book. It's been written by Lacey in year five. So shall we pray? Dear God, thank you for giving me the power to love my family, to love my friends, and to love God. Glory be to you, dear Lord, who is loved above all. Love is not just a feeling, it's an action. Help me to love through all I do. In Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Thank you, Lacey, for that very special prayer. I'm going to leave you now with the results of our creativity challenge part two. Let's have a look and see what's through the magical door.
The magical door and saw life before Corona.
I opened the magic door and I found my friends.
I opened the magical door and heard family and friends.
I opened the magic door and I saw the most beautiful and magnificent skyscrapers of the world.
Opened the magical door and felt happiness to be with my friend at the Blues.
I opened the magical door and heard my friends and me laughing and hugging.
I opened the magical door and saw people talking and playing together again.
I opened the magical door and saw my friends and family.
I opened the magical door and smelt Krispy Kreme donuts.
Yum! I opened the magical door and felt
the world was tidy, no longer a mess. Let's keep this world a better place.
I opened the magical door and smelt freedom.
I opened the magical door and saw my family running to cuddle me.
I opened the magical door and found my granddad.
I opened the magical door and taught football with my teammates. I miss so much.
After lockdown, we're going to have a big party and go to Hickory's and eat some popcorn chicken. This is my poem. I opened the magic door and heard people there. They were laughing and having fun at the fair. Bye-bye!
Now we are not afraid, although we know there's much to fear. We were moving mountains long before we knew we could. Oh yes, there can be miracles when you believe. Though hope is free, it's hard to kill. Who knows what miracles you can achieve when you believe? Somehow you will. You will when you believe. In vain, hope seems like the summer birds too swiftly flown away. Yet now I'm standing here. My I can't explain. Seeking faith and speaking words I never thought I'd.